since I had had a perfectly healthy pregnancy with my son, I avoided the doctor like the plague. And so I kept asking them if we could just do the anatomy ultrasound at 22 weeks instead of 19 or 20 where they would usually do it. And because I had had a healthy baby, they agreed with it. So it was like 22 weeks, 2 days when I went in for my anatomy ultrasound. He just kept scanning and scanning and he was very quiet, and we knew that something was going on then. I was just very caught off guard. You know, you think everything's fine, just like the last time, so it was difficult. That night is actually when I emailed Lurie Children's and said, can you help us? We made an appointment with Chicago Institute for Fetal Health, and it was a breath of fresh air. Even though we didn't really have any answers yet, we knew that somebody was gonna help us.
Our goal is that when that mother makes that contact, that everything she hears, everything she encounters from the first time she makes that call throughout her care is focused around her experience.
That first meeting is where we really learned like the ins and outs of what exactly they would be doing and, you know, what the risks are, what the positive outcomes could be.
Spina bifida affects 1 in 1,000 pregnancies. It's relatively common, and these children are born with a defect in their back, where there's no bone, no skin, and no muscle covering the spinal cord. The operation that we do for spina bifida is to actually go in before birth, close it and cover it, and put the spinal cord back inside. And that has shown to reverse and prevent those neurologic problems from happening. A child that may not have been able to walk independently can now walk independently.
When I was wheeled into the surgery room, I want to say there was at least 20 to 25 people there waiting and saying hello and that they were going to take care of me. She was so little, 2 pounds, 7 ounces. She was intubated for about 3 or 4 weeks. We waited 15 days to hold her. It's crazy to wait to hold your baby. People don't really understand what that's like. And so every day you're just standing there staring at her, waiting and waiting, and it was great. I think it's even more special when you have to wait that long to hold them. Right now we see physical therapy weekly, we see occupational and speech therapy at least monthly. Most likely without surgery, she would be paralyzed from the waist down, and right now she's working on standing. The Chicago Institute for Fetal Health at Lurie Children's is a lifesaver, life-changing. This is the greatest place on earth. We're just happy. We love them all so much, and they're like our family, whether they want to be or not.